Well, the planes were beautifully streamlined, and everybody was longing to get onto mosquitoes. And as a pilot and navigator, you sat and you were slightly offset because it was so narrow that you couldn't be side by side. And so you were a little bit behind him like that. And you were completely unarmed. You couldn't retaliate, but you did have a fairly bulletproof seat behind you, you know, great sheet of steel to protect you from night fighters winging in on behind you. But otherwise, you relied on speed, really speed, speed and height. We usually bombed at 25,000 feet, which is 5 miles high, isn't it? Give or take. And when we, it was the, well, they usually used to carry marker flares, which you'd drop on the target, yellow, green, I think, or red. I'm not certain on that, though that might have got confused with the fires. And you'd go in first and mark the target, which you'd marked by radar. And it wasn't chance that this happened next to water. You had your radar, and it sent out a beam, and if it came straight up again, it was bright green in the middle of your little map, which was just like that. If it hit ordinary ground, there was really a kind of a fuzzy sort of a return. If it hit water, it hit it and went off like that, so there was nil response. If it hit a town, it hit the pavement, then the wall and the roof, and you got back bright green. So you'd have your little map here, and you'd see, here there's lots of water, here there's a town at the edge of land. And it wasn't chance that Hamburg, Kiel, Bremen, indeed Cologne, all next to water, were first of all, and indeed Berlin was on the River Spree. It wasn't chance that they were first targeted by the Pathfinders, who went in with this new form of radar and marked the target, dropped their bombs, and then the heavies would come in with their big blockbusters. And of course, that was a 4,000-pound bomb, high in with a very low casing, and just enormous blast effect. And they really did blow down a whole block of buildings. So, and then of course, there was the form of radar, which I never was able to reach to. Doug Swain and I, my pilot, tried to move to it, which is why I did 52 raids, because at about 46, he said, if we aren't careful, if we do 50 raids, we'll be taken off and we'll be sent to training school. And he said, that's a fate worse than death. He said, let's transfer to Oboe, and then we'll be able to, having done 46 things, we'll be able to do 96 raids without being put onto a dull job.
Oboe was a new radar system.
It was a new radar system, and the boffins didn't know how good it was. They wanted to know, and so they sent out three planes, just three planes on one night, and it was to bomb a tiny little German cemetery, and really tiny little area. And then the next day they listened, and on the radio came the German propaganda person, speaking English, rather bad English, and he said, last night the British have bombed Germany. And there was not many bombs. And what is more, there was no casualties because these stupid British, they have bombed a cemetery. They said, yeah! They didn't have to get the resistance to give them a report back. They'd got it straight from the horse's mouth that it was accurate enough to hit perhaps an acre of target. And so Doug and I terribly wanted to be on Oboe. Well, I wasn't. I mean, I was on Pathfinders, but I wasn't on the elite of the elite. I was on the second grade.